trying to be a better person today, you feel me, than I was yesterday. That's what I strive for every day I wake up. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses. Give my people roses. When I die, I tell the homies, spell my name out. Light 100 candles for the low, bring the gang out. And if you go first, trust me, I'ma do the same. Turn them for a week just to take away the pain. Appreciate my niggas while they still here. Give my people roses while they still here. One day we gon' disappear. Like, damn, I was just with them. Got a call that the homie got shot and had his kids with him. Now I'm staring at the casket like, fuck. It's hard to say goodbye to somebody that you love. Respect to the dead, but appreciate the living. Cause when God call, I can't question this business. Give me my roses while I'm still here to smell them. I got people that I love that's gone and can't tell them. It shouldn't take a hood day or a funeral to tap in. We need to connect more like we did back then. I give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses. Give my people roses. This a dedication to niggas that I fuck with, appreciation due. Text my niggas all, call them out the blue. Like I love you, homeboy, just in case you never knew. Told my homegirl I'm proud of her. Know you been through a lot and you a proud mother. Last conversation, you was getting shit together. Know one thing for certain, man, shit don't last forever, right? One life to live, I got two fucks to give. Trying to mend a bridge between me and my kids. Build memories they can cherish and hold. Teach them never fall when the world get cold. Those are the things that mean the most to me. Not that fake love people show when you deceased. Gotta die to get love, you can keep it. I need all minds while I'm still here breathing. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses while they still here. Give my nigga roses while they still here. I give my people roses. Give my people roses. Snoopy Blue, Lifeline. Doing this for mines, every day. Dedicated to the living, spiritually wealthy.
It's like when I say I live the thug life, baby, I'm hopeless. One person might hear that and just like the way it sounds, you know what I'm saying? But I'm doing it for the kid that really lives a thug life and feels like it's hopeless. So when I say hopeless, and when I say it like that, it's like I reach him. You understand? And even if when I reach him, it makes it look glorious to the guy that doesn't live that life. I can't help it. It's a fad, you know. He'll drop the thug life soon enough. But for the person that I was trying to reach, he'll pick it up, and I'll be able to talk to him again.
Plus some liquor, homie, look, as a reminisce. September 13, 1996. Got four words, Pac, you'll forever be missed. Until this day, we still holding up your thesis. The hate you gave little infant fucked everyone. Then they wonder why youngest with the pop their guns. I swear this world's still crazy. You think I'm bullshitting, bro? Please ask Brenda, baby. How would you feel? Your own mom's tried to kill you. Ask for God for help, but even God can't feel you. Once again, rest in peace to my big homie. The only friend I had every time I felt lonely. Grew up with no moms, grew up with no pops. Just to make it through the day, had to pump too far. Work life, that's some real shit. If you felt how I felt, you would know it's some real shit. The government was scared of you. Player haters asking, man, what would Pop would do? Take that thought and they run with it. You was thugging, but the meaning big bro wasn't done with it. Sometimes I ask myself, where would I be? If the homie didn't lace me with the sister weight. Keep your head up, hold on, be strong. Why shed tears when Machiavelli is home?
It's nice and good, it's where it's all we need.
No time to breathe.
And this room, and justice all I see.
my last breath. No blasphemy, the homie had God steps to walk through. Better watch who you talk to. No stand, a Pac fan will haunt you. It's just music, it's deeper than the music. One nation is needed for this bullshit. My outlaws from the east to west. Yeah, we shed many tears when we felt that stress. Smoke me a blunt, this loud pack for Yaki. Yaki Gaddafi, ain't a cop here to stop me. You and I-T-Y. Real niggas don't die, real niggas just multiply. From the grave to the cradle. Man, I swear I hate cars every time I think of fatal. I'm struck worldwide and it's global. Can't wait to hit the lab with EDN Noble.
Spirits all we need. Keep on moving, there's no time.
Down to them as men or performers, but as elders, like, that's like if you see any old mob nigga coming, you know what I mean? Get that nigga table before you give me a table. Let him in before you let me in, because I do know I'm the Don there. But I know if I'm not the Don, I want that respect, because that to be the Don at one point means you had to have something.
Right.
And for him to write the message and all that shit, it did inspire me. It did do something. He got a pass. Unless he crossed me. And he hasn't. So we trying to get him a deal. He about to get a deal just using my name. And I got free and got rich just using his name and using his record.
Right.
I did the same thing to Nas, homie. I swear to God, I seen this nigga Nas at the House of Blues. I caught him out of pocket and everything. I was deep with my niggas. I know he didn't have no guns. We could have rushed him right there. I was like, what's up, yo? I said, yo, this East Coast, West Coast shit, it's not about you. Don't get caught up. And I swear to God, we love you. We got love for you. And I saw Wu-Tang, I saw Method Man, and like a couple months earlier, one of they niggas had got, he was in our club, 662, and somebody snatched his chain, you know, put hands on him. We got the chain back and found the niggas that did it. That's love. And I went to Method Man like, yo, we handled that, me and shit, want to talk to you. That was never our orders, no, that wasn't supposed to go down. We got the niggas that did it, we got the shit. Whenever, that's just me. You know what I mean? That's how we are. This nigga Nas went back home and started talking that fake thug and dropping little jewels and his shit. And that's wrong. Because you should have said that to me when I was right there. He knew his album said all this shit. And the nigga was like, don't do that. That means you're a punk. You know what I mean? I won't hug a nigga I don't like. That's why I'm telling you now, when I see Biggie, it's not going to be like we're going to attack him every time. I might be in a good mood, and I might not want to be going. This shit is so minor. This is not about me and Biggie. Everybody keep talking about it. Y'all making this nigga bigger than he is. Do you hear me fucking talking about this? This is a major plan, a major strategy. That was the impetus or the starter or the generator that kicked it off. They happen to be the regime before me. Just like Republicans hate Carter or whatever, now the Republicans is like, we can't wait for Bush to come back, you know? Just like now I'm in power, and everybody that love Biggie, they all like, I can't wait for Biggie to come back, or somebody like that, or Nas. That's why they root for them. They root for they people. And when I was gone, that's why all my niggas was like, we can't wait for them to come, and that's why they rushed the polls. They wanted a new regime. And my regime includes the East Coast. It includes the West Coast. It brings money. It's economics. You know what I mean? I study this shit. Yeah, I'm bringing money to New York by signing groups, by Death Row East. That's bringing money, economics, a sale. I'm bringing the bridge through this motherfucker. I want to start an athletic team where all the rappers sponsor a team.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm bringing the community involved. I'm giving money back to the community. We got Mother's Day, Thanksgiving, and Christmas so far, Death Row. We've been doing that. We're going to do it every year. Clothing, feeding, that's the welfare right there. We are the best choice for this fucking, to the millennium.
That's some hell shit, man, I'm telling you.
And I'm the only one in it like that. This nigga Biggie still talking about fucking Godfather. That's why I said to Nas when I did some of my records, you watch too many fucking movies. Right. Now who's gonna fucking follow you? These niggas talking about Al Pacino. They getting their Italians mixed up. Right. They like Al Pacino, Luciano. Right. That show you what type of niggas you dealing with. Only thing they like is the sound of an Italian nigga's name. The Italians I speak about were really truly great men. And I find any great man, black or white, I'm gonna study him, learn it, so he can't be great to me no more. Like Machiavelli. And that's why I don't say, my name's not Machiavelli, my name is Machiavelli. I took it, that's mine. He gave me that, you know what I mean? I took that, just like, and I don't feel no guilt. That motherfucker, all these motherfuckers stole from us forever. I'm taking back what's mine.
Right.
It's just that they recorded it when he said it. Right. It's probably something he took from us that they didn't let us record.
Right.
So there's no shame. You know what I mean?
Like Otis Redding,
yeah.
The Rolling Stones.
No doubt, no doubt. And I feel like I'm not on like people bashing like they are like on some. Why is niggas into this Italian mall? It's not about Italian shit, but all about studying. I studied the CIA, America. I hate America as for what we did, but I love us for being strong. You gotta do that. So what? We don't got a good image. We're the strongest motherfucking nation. That's me. That's me right fucking there. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck if y'all don't like me. I got the bomb. Can't nobody touch me. Won't nobody rush me. Something we doing right. That's that capitalism shit. Because you can feed your kids with that thought. All that other shit, you can't feed your kids with that. You can't feed your kids, you can't have a nation. So that's what's more important there. To me, do you take the discipline, the seriousness, and the bond that the mob has to take the enthusiasm, the morals, the principles that the Black Panthers had, the strength that the Black Panthers had, to take the camaraderie and the go all out with Gaddafi, all of us as a team that the police had, to take the nation is first attitude, whatever we gotta do to be number one, that United States take, and that's what makes me unstoppable. And take that nigga attitude that makes me look at all of that shit, study it, learn it, take the young African-American to have the talent to exhibit it, you know what I mean? And take the businessman, take the president, to take the philosopher to be able to break it down to an actual philosophy.
Right.
And that's what Illuminati is. But it's up to you to bring it to the people or else we're going to have an East Coast, West Coast war, because I'm not bowing down. I'm not going to say, you know, everything I did was righteous by the rules of war. You know what I mean? And they got to recognize that. But it's really like right now, it's not New York, because New York I love. If the writers, the radio people are using this as some way, they don't know what to talk about.
That.
Right. So that's what it's, and just like you sat down and thought about that nigga them shit, you can sit down and think how you can make people see it as clear as it is. Just like we on the same level. You look at things and you figure out how it's like a big plan to it. You know, it gotta be a big plan if this shit is happening. Like you were saying about me and Biggie being like politics. That's how I looked at it. Like, wait a minute, this shit is, I look at the rap game, like how it is. Like, every couple months, a whole new genre.
Yeah.
They'll say, like, they got a whole bunch of writers talking about gangster rap is dead. Those are the ones that don't like gangster rap.
Right.
That's like the writers that don't like Republicans. So they do that thing. They spin. You know what I mean? And then there's other ones that are like, Tupac drops the best. You know, boom, those are the ones that love it. Those are the radio people that love it. You know what I mean? And our job basically is not to, I don't want to see them dead, because the other side being the other side is that makes me the best man. You know what I thought when I was in jail? What fucked me up, what turned me like this, is I was like, no politicians is even getting at us. Even though I represent 5 million fucking fans. And no politicians is even checking for us. They're not even sending us nothing, trying to make us. They're not even thinking of it. And in business, you know, if you want to fuck with somebody, you know, you try to. They're not even looking at us like that. That means we ain't a threat.
Right, exactly.
But by the next election, I promise. By the next election, I promise. I'm going to be sitting across from all the candidates. I bet you. Now I'll be making it. I promise you. I'm not even gonna be, I'm gonna be so far from where I am now in 4 years. God willing, I'm alive. It's on, I guarantee you, we will have our own political party. And it won't be just for black people. It's gonna be for Mexicans. It's gonna be for Mexicans. It's gonna be for black people. It's gonna be for Armenians. I don't give a fuck. All you lost tribe motherfuckers right now, we need to have our own political party because we all have the same motherfucking stuff. Build this nation and we get none of the benefits. I already have famous record hits. I'm in this shit for the honor.